Hello students, welcome to physics class. Today we discuss about atomic spectra. In the previous lecture, we discussed energy of an electron and wavelength of emitted electromagnetic wave. Now we discuss about atomic spectra. So first one, in previous we discussed that Rutherford atomic model. According to Rutherford atomic model, he proposed that an electron revolve around the nucleus in any possible ready, it emits continuous spectrum, which is one of the drawbacks of Rutherford atomic model. But here, in case of Bohr's atomic model, he proposed that hydrogen-like atom emit discrete line spectrum, not continuous line spectrum, they emit discrete line spectrum. So first we discuss about what is continuous spectrum and what is discrete spectrum. Okay, so what happens if we take a source of incident light? That source must be white light source. Okay, that source is white light source, and take a prism in front of the white light source. Then what happened? Here dispersion occur. Okay, and here the dispersion occur and light scattering in form of different wavelength like violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red, like this rainbow color. Okay, this spectrum is called as continuous spectrum because it is in continuous manner. So this spectrum is called as continuous spectrum. Okay, continuous spectrum. Whereas if we take a hydrogen gas chamber which is full of hydrogen gas, Bohr and many scientists experiment on this. He take a gas chamber which is filled of hydrogen gas, okay, and provide heat energy. Then what happened? Here the electron is vibrated and the excited electrons of every atom radiate energy, but they have in particular wavelength. They have radiate energy but have particular wavelength and frequency, like blue, violet, red, in such way. Okay, violet, blue, red, in such way. They have in particular wavelength and particular frequency. This type of spectrum is called as line spectrum. Now we go through that in case of different transition, when electron make transition or jump from higher energy level to lower energy level, what is the amount of energy it radiate and what is the wavelength of the emitted radiation, so that we clearly understand about the line spectrum. Okay, at room temperature, electrons are in the innermost orbit, or that orbit take as n equals to 1. That orbit is called as the innermost orbit or ground state. Okay, at room temperature, that electron is at ground state and its energy E1 equals to minus 13.6 electron volt. When we provide energy to that atom, that electrons is vibrated and excited. So it jump from lower energy level to higher energy level. Any higher energy level that depends on the absorption of energy. What is the amount of energy it absorbs? According to that amount of energy, it jump from lower energy level to higher energy level. But what happened? In that ground state, that electron is more stable. But in that higher orbital state, in the higher excited state, that electron is unstable. Have become stable, that electron jump from higher excited state to lower excited state. To become stable, to acquire stability, that electron jump from higher excited state to the ground state. When it jump from higher excited state to lower excited state, or higher energy level to lower energy level, it emit energy in the form form of electromagnetic wave when it jumps from higher excited state to lower excited state. Okay, at that case it emit energy in the form of electromagnetic wave. When it jumps from higher excited state to lower excited state, we call as electron make transition from higher excited state to lower excited state. Okay, when electron make transition from any higher excited state to the ground state, that all the transition are in parallel line forms, are in all parallel line forms, and that is called as spectral series. That is called as spectral series. Now we go to when electron make transition from any higher excited state to the ground state, okay, they are in parallel lines of, they are in parallel lines, that is called a spectral series. Now the same structure is here, we take as this one is the first orbit N1, that is called as ground state or the first orbit. Then the second state, that is the second orbit but first excited state. First excited state or second orbit. This one is the first orbit and ground state. This one is the second orbit but first excited state. Likewise, this one is second excited state and this one is third excited state. Likewise, okay? Third excited state. Likewise, we go through the above. Now, what happened when electron make transition from 2 to 1? When electron make transition from 2 to 1, okay, any higher excited state to the ground state, that series is invented by Lehmann and that series is called as Lehmann series. Okay guys, this one is when electron makes transition from 2 to 1. Here electron makes transition from 3 to 1. That means 1 means orbital number is 1. Number of orbit, that is 1. But here is the ground state. Okay, and further 4 to 1. N equals to 4 to N equals to 1. Then further N equals to 5 to N equals to 1. Then further N equals to 6 to N equals to 1. Next N equals to 7 to N equals to 1. Then this series is invented by Lehmann. So this series is called as Lehmann series. Then here what happened? This one is the first energy level. This one is the second energy level. This one is the third energy level. Likewise fourth energy, fifth energy level. Okay. Then here the difference between these two energy level, that is maximum. Whereas here the difference between E5 to E4, that difference is minimum. Okay, here the difference between the two energy level E2 to E1, that is maximum. Whereas in between E4 to E5, that energy level, that is minimum. And if we becomes go to that, the difference between E5 to E6, that difference is also minimum. As we go to the higher state, that energy difference between the two energy level gradually decreases. As we go to the higher state, energy difference between two energy level, that is gradually decreases. Here minus 13.6 electron volt and this one equals to 3.4 electron volt. Here this difference is maximum compared to this one, that is 0.85, and this one equals to 0.54. That difference is less, whereas this difference is maximum. Okay, now another topic. If electron make transition from N equals to 2 to N equals to 1, okay, what is the amount of energy it radiates? That E equals to the energy difference between E2 to E1, E2 minus E1, where E2 is the higher excited state and E1 is the lower excited state. E2 is the higher excited state in which excited state electron make transition. That state is called as E2 and E1 is the lower excited state. So what happened here? E2 to E1, that energy difference, that is minimum compared to when electron make transition from E7 to E1. When electron make transition from E7 to E1, that energy difference is greater compared to E2 to E1. Okay, so here that wavelength, if we consider this one, we know that E equals to hc by lambda. In which state energy is maximum at that transition? discern that electromagnetic wave that is minimum, in which state energy difference is minimum. Energy difference is minimum. At that case, wavelength is maximum. Okay, like here we discuss evaluate lambda maximum and lambda minimum, longer wavelength and shorter wavelength. We discuss later. Next, if electron make transition from any higher excited level to the second orbit or to the first excited state, that is called as Balmer series, and that series is invented by Balmer. So that series is called as Balmer series. Here, that electron make transition from any higher excited orbit to the second orbit or first excited state. That series is called as Balmer series. Next, when the electron make transition from any higher excited orbit to the third orbit, any higher excited orbit to the third orbit or second excited state, that is called as Pasteur series. Okay, Pasteur series, that is invented by Pasteur, and that series is called as Pasteur series. Likewise, when electron make transition from any higher excited orbit to the fourth orbit or third excited state, that series is invented by Brackett, and that series is called as Brackett series. Okay, likewise, when electron make transition from any higher excited state to the n equals to 5, that orbit is n equals to 5, that series is invented by Pepin, and that series is called as Pepin series. And in every case, we determine lambda maximum and lambda minimum. Let's start Lehmann series. So in case of Lehmann series, what happen? That electron make transition from any higher excited orbit to the ground state. Okay, so if we take that electron make transition from second orbit to the first orbit, here N2 equals to 2 and here N1 equals to 1. Okay, the first orbit 1 and electron make transition from 2 to 1. So N2 equals to 2, N1 equals to 1. And here how much energy it radiate? That E equals to E2 minus E1, where E2 is the higher excited state energy level and E1 is the lower excited state energy level. Okay, now if electron take transition from N equals to 4 to N equals to 1, and that in that case of E2, we put the energy of N equals to 4. That means we put the energy level of E4 minus E1. That means here what happened? E2 is symbolized the excited state, higher excited state, where E1 is symbolized the lower excited state, or the, in case of Lehmann series, the ground state. Now, in the previous lecture, we discussed that how we calculate wavelength, and then 1 by lambda equals to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square, where R is the Rydberg constant, its value is 1.09 into 10 to the power 7 meter inverse, and 1 by R equals to 911 angstrom, we already discussed in the previous lecture. Now, here we calculate for Lehmann series what is the wavelength. Take that as electron make transition from any higher excited state to the ground state, at that case N1 equals to 1. For Lehmann series, N1 equals to 1 and N2 is equals to 2, 3, 4 up to infinity. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to infinity. So what is infinity? For an atom, if electron is at 1 centimeter or 2 centimeter from the nucleus, for an atom, if electron is 1 centimeter or 2 centimeter distance from the nucleus, then it seems to be that electron is at infinity distance, because that size of the nucleus or the size of the atom is very, very, very small. So if electron is 1 centimeter or 2 centimeter distance from the nucleus, that means electron is at infinity distance. You clear? Now we go to to 1, 2 to 1. At that case, n2 equals to 2, n1 equals to 1. So what is the wavelength? We put the formula 1 by lambda equals to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square, 1 by n1 square. That means 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 2 square. Okay, solve this one. 1 by lambda equals to that value r into 1 by 1 minus 1 by 4. Then solve this one r, this one equals to 4. Then 4 minus 1. 4 r into 4 minus 1 by 4. Then this one equals to 3 r by 4. Then what is lambda? Lambda equals to 4 by 3 r. Or lambda equals to 4 by 3 into 1 by r. Then 1 by r equals to 911 angstrom. So this one equals to 4 by 3 into 911 angstrom. This value equals to lambda equals to 1216 angstrom. This value equals to 1216 angstrom. But here what happened? When electron make transition from 2 to 1. Okay, when electron make transition from 2 to 1. That energy radiate, that is minimum. We know that E equals to hc by lambda. So as energy is minimum, so that wavelength should be maximum. Here we got maximum wavelength or longer wavelength. Okay, then what is the shorter wavelength? What is the shortest wavelength? If electron make transition from n equals to infinity to n equals to 1, when electron make transition from infinity to 1, at that case energy transition, that is maximum, so wavelength of this emitted radiation, that is minimum. Okay, if electron make transition from infinity to 1, at that case infinity to 1, at that case energy, emitted energy, that is maximum. If emitted energy maximum, then wavelength of the emitted radiation, that is minimum. Okay, then we put that value and calculate it. You write down this one, then we go through that. If electron make transition from infinity to 1, what is that wavelength? Students who watch this video, make sure you are sit with your notebook so you can understand properly and write this in the sequence. Now what happens, students? In every transition, we saw that wavelength is in different way. Take that, when electron make transition 2 to 1, we got that lambda 2 1 equals to 1216 angstrom. Then when electron make transition from 3 and orbit n equals to 3 to n equals to 1, then here that wavelength, that is equals to 1024 angstrom. In the same procedure, we put this one, 1 by r into 1 by 1 n1 square minus 1 by n2 square, that means 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 3 square, and we calculate this one. Then if electron make transition from n equals to 4 to n equals to 1, then in similar way you put this one and calculate the wavelength that that electron make transition from 4 to 1. Lambda 4 1 equals to 971 angstrom. And we discuss that if electron make transition from infinity to 1, at that case energy, that is emitted energy, that is maximum, so that wavelength is minimum. How we got this? That n1 equals to 1 and n2 equals to infinity, because electron make transition from infinity to 1, so n2 equals to infinity, so 1 by lambda infinity to 1, r equals to 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Here n1, 1 square minus 1 by infinity square, 1 by infinity square, that means this one equals to 0, so 1 by lambda equals to r, 1 by 1 square, that is equals to 1, so 1 by lambda equals to r, so lambda equals to 1 by r. So what is the value of 1 by r? That 1 by r equals to 911 angstrom. So when electron make transition from infinity to 1, and that case that wavelength equals to 911 angstrom. So what happened? In every transition, the wavelength, if we calculate that wavelength not in continuous manner. The wavelengths are in particular manner. That means in the first wavelength, that is 1216 angstrom. Further that one, 1024 angstrom. Next one, 971 angstrom. Next one, 911 angstrom. Then that are in a particular manner, not in continuous. If it is in continuous manner, that 1216 angstrom, that next one equals to 1215 angstrom. The next one equals to 1214 angstrom. They are not like this. If first one equals to 1216 angstrom, then the next one equals to 1024 angstrom. So in every transition, a particular wavelength is arises. So they are in line spectrum form, not in continuous form. They are have particular wavelength. So this is called as line spectrum. Okay, that means in continuous form, what happened? If one is 12, then 13, 14, 15, up to 20. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, up to 20. This one is continuous form. If we take 12, 15, 18, 20, they are not in continuous form. They are in particular form. That is called as line spectrum. You got it? I think you all clear this topic. In the similar way, we go through the Bulmer series. Now we go to Bulmer series. In case of Bulmer series, what happens? That electron may transition from any higher orbit to the lower orbit, to the lower orbit, half orbital number 2, or the first excited state. Electron may transition from the orbit 2 or second orbit, or called as electron may transition from any higher excited state to the first excited state. Here what happened? Due to electron make transition from any higher excited state to the orbital number 2, n1 equals to 2, and n2 any higher orbit, the 3, 4, 5, 6 up to infinity, n2 equals to 3, 4, 5, 6 infinity. Now we take one example, when electron make transition from 3 to 2, so n1 equals to 2 and n2 equals to 3, we put the value. That 1 by lambda equals to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square, 1 by n1 square, that 2 square 4 and 3 square 9, and solve this one so that we got this wavelength, that 9, 4, the 36, then you solve equals to 5 r by 36, then lambda 32, 3, 2 equals to 36 by 5 into 1 by r. 36 by 5 R, that is 36 by 5 into 1 by R. 1 by R equals to 911 angstrom, and multiplying this one we got 6559 angstrom. Next, if electron may transition from n equals to 4 to n equals to 2, so n1 equals to 2 and n2 equals to 4. In the similar way, you put the value 1 by n1 square, the 2 square, minus 1 by n2 square, that is 4 square, and solve the procedure. Then lambda 4 2 equals to 4858 angstrom. Okay, here what happened? In that case of Bulmer series, this wavelength is the larger wavelength, maximum wavelength. This one is the maximum wavelength or larger wavelength. Okay. And what is the shortest wavelength or shortest wavelength? This one is the shortest wavelength. So what happened here? Electron make transition from infinity to 2. Electron make transition from infinity to 2. At that case, energy radiated, that is maximum. So wavelength, that is minimum. Okay. Then as electron make transition from infinity to 2, n1 equals to 2 and n2 equals to infinity, then 1 by lambda equals to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Then 1 by infinity, that is 0. Okay, then 1 by 2 square, that is 4, r by 4. So lambda infinity 2 equals to 4 by r. So 4 into 1 by r, 1 by r, that is 911 angstrom. Okay, 911 angstrom. So what is the value? That infinity to 2, 3644 angstrom. That is 3644 angstrom. So what happened here? That the maximum wavelength or the longer wavelength, that is 6559 angstrom, that is nearer to the wavelength of red light. Whereas, in case of when electron make transition from 4 to 2, that wavelength is 4858 angstrom. That wavelength is nearly equal to the wavelength of blue light. And if electron make transition from infinity to 2, that value equals to 3644 angstrom. That means that is the wavelength of the violet light. Okay, so what happened here? VIBGYOR, that is the continuous spectrum. But here what happened? One is violet light obtained, another one blue light wavelength obtained, another one red light wavelength obtained. Okay, so here 3 to 1, that wavelength is nearer to the red light wavelength. Then 4 to 2, that wavelength is nearly equal to the blue light wavelength. Okay, so here not in continuous manner radiation occurs, that radiation is in particular manner, or that radiation is called as that line spectrum. That radiation which occurs, that is in the form of line spectrum. Okay, now what happened here? That in the case of Balmer series, that radiation is lies between 3644 angstrom to 6559 angstrom. That means that is belongs to the region of visible region. Violet to red, that is lies or belongs to the region of visible region. That means Balmer series, your radiation occur, that radiation belongs to the visible region. That radiation belongs to the visible region. Whereas in case of Lehmann series, okay, that wavelength lies between 1216 angstrom to 911 angstrom. That is belongs to the region of ultraviolet region. Ultraviolet region. Okay. Ultraviolet region. Next one we go to, in the similar way we determine the maximum wavelength and minimum wavelength for Pasten series, Brackett series and Pithom series. In case of Pasten series, N1 equals to 3 and N2 equals to 4, 5 up to infinity. In case of Brackett series, N1 equals to 4 and N2 equals to 5, 6 up to infinity. And in case of Pithom series, N1 equals to 5 and N2 equals to 6, 7, 8, 9 up to infinity. In the similar way, you can determine the maximum wavelength and minimum wavelength for Pasten, Brackett and Pithom series. Now we go to some numericals of this topic. Here the question is given, the energy of an electron in the nth orbit is En equals to minus 13.6 electron volt by n square. Calculate the energy required to excite an electron. Okay, calculate the amount of energy required to excite an electron from ground state to the second excited state. First one, this one is ground state. Ground state having energy E1, and then first excited state having energy E2, and second excited state having energy E3, where in ground state n equals to 1 and have first excited state n equals to 2 and second excited state n equals to 3. That orbital number is 3, but the excited state, that is the second excited state. So for ground state E1 equals to minus 13.6 divided by 1 square. Okay, then this one equals to minus 13.6 electron volt. Then E second excited state, E second excited state means E3. Then E3 equals to minus 13.6 by n square. Your second excited state means n equals to 3. So 3 square, that is the electron volt. Okay, electron volt. Then this one equals to minus 13.6 divided by 3 square. That is the answer equals to minus 1.51 electron volt. Then here the question is, calculate the energy by which an electron is excited from the ground state to the second excited state. Electron make transition from 1 to 3. So how much amount of energy required? That E equals to E3 minus E1. कितने amount of energy दरकार होगा? 1 to 3 को जवाब है. E3 minus E1. Put the value E3, that is minus 1.51 minus of minus 13.6 electron volt. Then the total answer equals to minus 1.51 plus 13.6 6 electron volt, then this one equals to 12.09 electron volt. Okay. Now the second question is, find the transition which result in the emission of a photon of wavelength 496 nanometer. First one, here the question is that wavelength is 496 nanometer. Wavelength is 496 nanometer. That means we first convert that wavelength into meter. Then lambda equals to 496 nanometer. That is equals to 496 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. Clear? Next, what is the transition? Find out the transition. First one, in transition, what is the total amount of energy? If we calculate, then we calculate what are the transition occur, in which transition that electron go from which orbit to which orbit faster. What is the energy here in transition? What is the energy that radiate? E equals to that formula hc by lambda. Okay, acha. So what is h? That is 6.63 into 10 to the power 34 joule per second. That is the Planck's constant. C, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second divided by lambda, this one, 496 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. Here this one meter per second, here joule per second. So joule second. So calculate this one, we got, okay, here meter, meter cancel, second, second cancel, then that answer is in the form of joule, is in the form of joule. Okay, but we calculate that energy in the form of electron volt. So first, 1 electron volt is equals to how much joule? 1 electron volt equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So what is 1 joule? 1 joule equals to 1 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 electron volt. Okay, so this much joule equals to how much electron volt? This much into 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 electron volt. So E equals to, put the value, 6.63 into 10 to the power 34 into 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 496 into 10 to the power minus 9 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 electron volt. Solve this one, we got, okay, if you solve this one, we got 2.55 electron volt. 2.55 electron volt.